stand up for Jesus.
First Samuel 14, I'm going to be reading from the King James here. It says, "Now it happened one day that Jonathan, the son of Saul, said to the young man who wore his armor, 'Come, let us go over to the Philistines' garrison that is on the other side.' He did not tell his father, and Saul was sitting in the outskirts of Gibeah under a pomegranate tree, which is in Micron. The people who were with him were about 600. Ahijah, the son of Ahitub, Ichabod's brother, the son of Phinehas, the son of Eli, the Lord's priest in Shiloh, was wearing an ephod. The people did not know that Jonathan had gone. Between the passes by which Jonathan sought to go over the Philistines' garrison were the sharp rock on one side and a sharp rock on the other. The name of one of his was Bozez, and the name of the other, Seneh. The front one faced northward opposite Mishmash, and the other opposite Gibeah. Then Jonathan said to the young man who wore his armor, 'Come, let us go over to the garrison of these uncircumcised. It may be that the Lord will work for us. For nothing restrains the Lord, save by many or by few.' So his armor bearer said to him, 'Do all that is in your heart. Go then, here I am with you, according to your heart.' Then Jonathan said, 'Very well. Let us cross over to these men. We will show ourselves to them.' Yet they say thus to us, wait until we come to you, then we will stand still in our place and not go up to them. But if they say, come up to us, then we'll come up. For the Lord has delivered them into our hand, and this will be a sign to us. So both of them showed themselves to the garrison of Philistines. And the Philistines said, look, the Hebrews are coming out of the holes they have hidden. Then the men of the garrison called to Jonathan and his armor bearer and said, come up to us, we will show you something. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father God, here, this is a great message here we have in the scripture. It tells us about the faith here of Jonathan. Faith that moved him in courage, him and his armor bearer. He showed great faith that day. The faith that a king had, who was his father, but his father's faith was very fleeting. Father God, let Jonathan be an example to us. Father, we pray that your spirit here would be with us, that we can have that faith and show courage. We can have that faith in opposition to our enemies, enemies that we've seen that are just unconquerable or informal, yet with your spirit, they're not. Father God, we ask for a blessing for all of us here today. We ask this in your son's name. Amen.
Amen.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
You may be seated. Amen. And the other portion of that verse 12 says that God delivered them into the hands of Jonathan. Isn't that neat? The man had faith, his brother was praying. The man had faith, and because of faith, he was able to see tremendous victories in spite of all the opposition. I trust everybody's doing good. Would you wave at me quickly? Would you wave at me? Say, good morning, Pastor. Would you say, good morning, Pastor? Amen. This is a good day. We've got a full day today.
Because I know I will dwell with him one day.
Amen.
Especially since I